Join the music revolution with iTunes and make your music devices about 10 times more valuable. That's iTunes.
That day, iTunes 1.0 was released, giving consumers a place to rip and organize their music collection. In 2003, iTunes unveiled a full music store where customers could download full albums or single songs for as little as 99 cents per song.
Regardless of iTunes, the industry itself was already on a downward turn.
Glenn Camarada, manager of Crossroads Music and Movies in Blacksburg, Virginia, has worked for the company long enough to see the evolution of iTunes and its effects on the business. While the store has taken a hit on its music sales, its movie sales and rentals have combated the negative effect of online music. The store has also gone to selling sports memorabilia, incense, and other items to help gain some revenue, but its effect has been less than minimal.
Do you want my honest opinion on that stuff? I think having all that sports gear here is ridiculous and it's a waste of money. If the owners really wanted to make money, you wouldn't buy stuff that is already available in 5 dozen other stores in town.
Len went on to say that he thinks the money should be used elsewhere to update their inventory system or to purchase more movies or even vinyl, which he has seen make a resurgence in the industry.
Vinyl sales are on the increase. CD sales are on the decrease. Now, still only like 3 million sales a year versus 40 million sales a year, but it was 2 million last year. You know, that's a 30% increase. That's pretty good.
One business that did not hop on the vinyl resurgence is commercial retailer FYE. No more than 5 miles west of Crossroads, FYE closed its doors in Christiansburg in early 2010. It's not difficult for Camarada to see why they are still in business in the New River Valley and why FYE is not.
We're way cooler. I mean, that sounds arrogant as shit, doesn't it? I'm sorry. But commercial stores have no control over anything. You go to FYE, okay? You're buying a CD at 1982 prices, at $19 for a CD that's 10 years old. Okay, people complain that we charge a lot, but the reason we charge a little bit more than, say, Target is because we can only afford to buy 4 or 5 copies of a CD, or they can afford to buy 4 or 5,000 copies of a CD.
Matt Lee, store manager of FYE in Roanoke, Virginia, does not deny the fact that their prices for older CDs are higher, but he says that the store is working hard to bring low prices and exclusive content on new music to their customers.
Well, here lately they've come out with like some exclusive CDs that only have certain tracks on them that you can't get online. So you have to actually buy the CD at the store to get the extra tracks on it. And I hope they continue to do that, because that's a good way to do that.
In addition to the exclusive content, Lee believes that the chain has gone the same route as Crossroads has to bring in additional revenue. The store has a wide range of clothing, music accessories, candy, and drinks to bring in more money. Unlike most mom-and-pop shops, however, the chain has tried to ride the wave of digital music instead of fighting it.
Now, we do have a store in the same town here in Roanoke, a freestanding store on Electric Road. And they have a mix and burn machine in the store now, which means a customer walks in and says, I want to order Led Zeppelin 2. Don't have it in the store. It's going to take a week or two to come in. If they have it on their machine, they can burn a copy in the store for the customer. And it takes 15, 20 minutes. It does print out the front cover and the song titles, not the liner notes. But, you know, it's available. This customer can get it right then and there.
FYE has also gone the route that both Walmart and Amazon have gone by offering 99-cent downloads of songs through their website, just as iTunes does. Just try to keep my customers satisfied, But what do the consumers feel about iTunes? By the sales, it's pretty evident that the program isn't going anywhere anytime soon. As of February 2010, 10 billion songs had already been downloaded. But for some people, iTunes just doesn't have the same feel to it as actually purchasing an album.
I especially love the artwork as an artist. It's always cool to see especially with hip-hop albums, the graffiti influence or like a lot of the different graphic design work that goes into it.
Andy is somewhat of a special example, as there seems to be a generational gap in the appreciation for buying the physical album.
Do you think that the younger generation will appreciate that physical copy of an album now that they're kind of growing up on iTunes?
No, the ones that are really growing up on iTunes don't. I found that the ones that collect the albums and really seem to have more of an appreciation for that, their parents have large record collections.
But for the generation growing up on iTunes, they will experience problems parallel to a scratched or broken CD. Many users have complained about the amount of memory iTunes takes up on their computer. There are also many complaints about the program shutting down unexpectedly or the loss of their entire music library. Problems or not, it's evident that iTunes is here to stay. Apple has created numerous ways to access the program through MacBooks, iPods, iPads, iPhones, and iTouches. The record stores realize this, and it is ultimately up to them to figure out how to beat this digital wave.
But it's really hard to say. I mean, I would hope we would stay around because as these other big chains, big boxes, reduce their sections, we're going to be the only ones that's going to have like back catalog, and we're going to be the only ones you can come to buy a physical CD anymore. So I'm hoping that we will last for a good while, and maybe the trend to be more people wanting the physical copy more now. I hope so.
While FYE remains optimistic about their future, it's hard for the smaller stores like Crossroads to do so, since they do not have the money to make the equipment upgrades, technological upgrades, and catalog upkeep needed to stay in the ring with iTunes.
I think stores like that are really neat, you know, because yeah, I just like to find an old CD or something for a cheap price, because I like the artwork and I like the original CD better than I do downloading the MP3s. But if they can hang on, it'll be a miracle.
Where do you see the store in about 5 years?
Gone.
Bum, 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 bum.